hope you all are doing great. So today I'm here with 10 amazing yogasanas for dyspnea with its scientific background. So dyspnea is a major problem faced by each and every girl during her menses period. Dyspnea is nothing but it is a painful menstruation. So it can be literally translated as difficult monthly flow. It can be divided in two groups such as primary and secondary. Primary dyspnea is defined as a painful menses in women with normal pelvic anatomy usually begins during adolescence. Whereas secondary dyspnea is menstrual pain that is generally related to some kind of gynecological disorders. Now let's move into its causes behind it. The cause behind the primary dyspnea is prostaglandins, an hormone. Hormone that makes our uterus contract during menstruation as well as during the time of delivery. The pain results from the release of these hormones when the lining of the endometrium is shedding off during the menstrual period. Now let's see the causes of secondary dyspnea. It may be because of any fibroid, any sexually transmitted infection or pelvic inflammatory diseases or any sort of tumor or cyst, etc. Now let's move into some risk factors which may make the condition more worsen. The first one is nulliparity, second is heavy menstrual flow, third is smoking, fourth is physical inactivity, fifth is disruptions of social networks, and the sixth one is depression and anxiety. These factors contribute to increase the risk of dyspnea. Now let's move on to the role of yoga in curing dyspnea. First of all, yoga reduces the pain, severity and duration of primary dyspnea. The yoga poses are safe and simple treatment which involves in treating primary dyspnea. With yogic exercises, the stress and pain of dyspnea can be controlled. It also reduces the psychological stress level and it can be implemented among college students in order to maintain and balance the menstrual well-being. Additionally, psychological stresses can directly provoke transient increase in pro-inflammatory cytokines. Yoga reduces symptoms of anxiety and depression. It also reduces the sympathetic nervous system tone and increases its vagal activity, both of which could have favorable endocrine and immune consequences, including lowering the inflammations. Now let's look into the 10 mesmerizing asanas for dyspnea. First one is Navasana. It works on hip flexors, abdominalis and adductor muscles. But it seems many people misunderstand the nature of the boat pose. Sure, your abdominal muscles will support you in this pose, but the real co-star of the show are your hip flexors. Specifically, your iliopsoas and rectus femoris muscles, which helps in strengthening the pelvic muscle. And second one is Theetali Asana, the butterfly pose, which renders a great stretch for the inner thighs and groin region. It relaxes the tensed tissue and improves the flexibility of the region. It also improves blood circulation in the lower body. Third one is Dhanurasana, the bow pose, which stretches the ankle, thighs, groin, abdomen and chest region and also involves in stretching the deep hip flexor muscles. It also strengthens the back muscles and also good for PCOD. Fourth one is Vajrasana. Vajrasana alters the flow of blood and nervous impulses in your pelvic region and strengthens your pelvic muscles, alleviating menstrual disorders. It also fires up your digestive system and reduces stomach troubles. Fifth is Shashangasana. Shashangasana stretches your back, realigns your vertebra correctly and also the surrounding nerves. It regulates the functioning of your adrenal gland. It tones and strengthens the pelvic muscles and sciatic nerves. It also relieves constipation and reduces the anger and cools the brain. Sixth is Ustrasana. It stimulates the abdominal organ, increases the blood flow to the uterus, helping it to heal faster. It also relieves backache and helps our body to relax. Seventh one is Ardha Machendrasana. It increases the circulation to the pelvic region and therefore provides fresh blood and nutrients and oxygen to the particular area. It improves the health of the reproductive organs as well as the urinary system. It is useful asana for preventing the urinary tract infection. 8th one is Shalabhasana. This asana helps in regulating the acid-base balance in our body. It also involves in relieving the stress and anxiety. 9th one is Bhujangasana. Gynecological problems like lycorrhea, dysmenorrhea, syphilis, amenorrhea, etc. is greatly benefited from this yoga pose. It is beneficial for the health of the ovary and uterus. And it is also good for menstrual cycle and menstrual disorders. 10th is Marjari Asana, the cat pose. Marjari Asana improves the flexibility of our spine, neck and shoulders. Gently toning the reproductive system, it also involves in curing the menstrual disorders and also curing lycorrhea. It also involved in secretion of serotonin along with brain-derived neurotropic factor, which together involve in antidepressant effect. So we have completed the 10 mesmerizing asanas for curing dysmenorrhea. I hope this will be very useful information to all of you. So beyond these 10 asanas, there are also several other asanas which involves in curing dysmenorrhea. But this 10 asanas takes the top 10 position. So you can also add up Surya Namaskara along with this if it is necessary. So I hope you got some idea regarding dysmenorrhea and its yogic management. If you like this video, please put up thumbs up and subscribe our channel for more information. Thank you, stay happy and stay healthy.